Welcome back to my channel and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll teach you how to pronounce Thai dishes correctly. It's gonna save your time for ordering a lot. So please watch until the end of the video. I saw some channels, they teach how Thai people pronounce English words or borrow words with a Thai accent. And some people here even asked me to do that as well. I don't think I'll do it. Here is the reason. Because they are English words, so Thai people should learn how to pronounce them correctly, like native speakers, or at least as close as possible. So I'm not encouraging you to speak in a wrong way like Gus. Either speak English like a Thai. Some of my students, he speaks like, "I'm not a beginner." And I was like, "What?" And it's kind of annoying. And he is a European. When I met or hear foreigners speak English like that, I don't want to talk to them, honestly. But I do encourage you to pronounce Thai dishes that I'm about to give you correctly. In this video, I'll teach you how to pronounce Thai dishes correctly. It's gonna save your time for ordering a lot. That means your life will be easier if you know how to say them in Thai. Because if these dishes described in English or written in menu, they are need at least two rows to fill the name of a dish. Top 20 dishes are based on my experience that I have been asked people. They are just random order, nothing in particular. This is my favorite dish, this is the most popular. Nope, just sort by my feelings. So please watch until the end of the video because you might find your new favorite Thai dishes. So let's begin. Number one, Phat Ka Phrao. This is the answer that I got the most when I asked foreigners, what is your favorite Thai dish? One thing that I want you to notice is Ka Phrao, spelled correctly, has only Ro Rua at Phrao, not Ka. If you see in a menu spelled like this, please let them know that they are misspelling. Phat Ka Phrao is foreigner's favorite dish, right? But for Thai, if you go to a restaurant and order Ka Phrao, we call Ahan Sin Khit or Menu Sin Khit, meaning you are just lazy to think what to eat and end up at Ka Phrao. What types of meat do you like to add to your Ka Phrao? Hmoo, hmoo, sap, gung, neua, gai, thale. Number two, Khao Soi Gai. This dish is one of my favorite dishes. It just tastes so good. It is slightly spicy, sour and creamy, but be careful, don't eat too much. You might gain weight from coconut milk. Pay attention when you order in a restaurant that they have more than khao soi gai because you might get khao soi, which means steamed rice. So please pronounce correctly. Khao soi, khao soi gai, khao soi, khao soi, khao soy. Number three, Phat Si Eeu. Phat Si Eeu is fast food that we call Ahan Jan Diao in Thai. The direct translation is one dish, which means you can only eat the dish on its own without eating it with rice or another side dish. To observe if the dish will be delicious or not, it's by the way the noodles look. If they look greasy and stays together, it simply means that this will taste terrible for sure. Number four, Gung Chae Nam Pla. Gung Chae Nam Pla. This one is also one of my favorite dish. Some restaurants serve the sauce with a cup, but some they add the sauce on top of the prawns. So it's kind of spicy. Be careful, don't eat a big bite. One thing is you have to get this dish in a clean and reliable restaurant. If the prawns are not fresh and clean, your stomach might get upset in the next day or even immediately. Number five, Phat Thai. Phat Thai. It's pronounced Phat Thai, not Phat Thai or Pad Thai. This list won't be top and complete if I don't add this dish. Is there anybody here haven't tried this dish? Even if you have had, did you know that can use your noodles? It doesn't have to be like this, and this dish can be served without any noodles. Yep, you have heard it right. We call Pad Thai Rai Sen, which literally means Pad Thai without noodles. Does it look good? If yes, you definitely should try it. Number 6. Massaman. This dish is the second answer I have got when I asked non-Thai, what is your favorite Thai dish? Personally, I don't like this dish much because it contains coconut milk. Massaman is especially famous for being a Thai Muslim dish that has flavor influence from Persia. Number 7. Tom Kha Gai. Tom Kha Gai. This dish contains coconut milk again. If you are a person who is concerned about high cholesterol, the dish is not recommended. But if you're kind of person that doesn't care about the taste and nutrition, then add this dish to your favorite dish. Number 8. Som Tam. Som Tam. This one is one of my favorite dishes. Som Tam can be customized in a ton of different ways. When you change the ingredients, the way to call will also change, such as Tam Pa. This one is my favorite, but you can't expect every restaurant add the same ingredients when you go to a new place. But if you don't like the ferment fish sauce that we call Pra Ra, don't worry, Tam Thai is your option. Som Tam is originally from Isan, which is my hometown. Nowadays, restaurants add ingredients to make their Som Tam unique. You will find Som Tam with raw prawn, squid, or even salmon. Number 9. Gang Kiao Wan. Gang Kiao Wan. This dish might be the first thing that pops up to your head when talking about Thai food. It can be a little bit spicy for you if you are not a big fan of spicy dish. Green curry normally served with rice, but it tastes so good with rice noodle, or known as Khanom Jin as well. Number 10. Khao Man Gai. Khao Man Gai. Khao Man Gai is ahan jan diao, same as Pad Si Iu. It's common to have Khao Man Gai for breakfast. You will find it in a night market that they open late. If you don't want the skin when ordering, you can say Mai Ao Nang Krab. Mai Ao Nang Ka. Some places they serve sauce on top, but some they serve in a small cup. It's a little bit spicy, so don't put too much when you eat. Number 11. Nam Tok Mu. Nam Tok Mu. Nam Tok doesn't mean waterfall. It comes from the juice that come out from the pork when we grill it. The juice drop to the fire. When the pork is done, they slice it and add ingredients. The dish tastes hot and spicy and sour from lamb. I highly recommend, and this dish is originally from Isan again. Number 12. Nua Dat Diao. Nua Dat Diao. If you are a meat lover, I highly recommend this dish. Dat means sunlight and Diao means alone. This way of cooking can be adjusted for fish and pork, but beef is the best. The taste will be even better if you have this with Som Tam or Khao Niao. Number 13. Khanom Jin Nam Ya. Khanom Jin Nam Ya. Or you can call Khanom Jin. Khanom Jin is the name of soft rice noodles that are ever so slightly fermented. They can be compared to really thin spaghetti noodles, but made from rice. Nam Ya is a coconut curry often made with fish, served over the soft rice noodles and topped with a variety of fresh raw veggies. It's a miraculous combination. Nam Ya has some varied options which can be more spicy and taste a lot different to the standard one. So get out and try them and see which one suits your taste buds. Number 14. Tap wan, tap wan. I don't know why it's called tap wan when it's not sweet at all. Tap wan has similar ingredients to nam tok, but uses pork liver as the main ingredient. If you like nam tok, you are likely to love this dish. Number 15, pa nang. Panang. This dish can be customized with any meat. The texture and taste is similar to gang kiao wan, but it's more creamy and more spicy. If you haven't tried it, it's time to give it a go. Number 16. Kao kluk gapi. Kao kluk gapi. Chim paste fried rice is served with a variety of side dishes. In the dish, you will experience almost every taste, whether it be the saltiness from the shrimp paste, the sweetness from the Chinese sauces and sweet pork, the sourness from the mango. You can add fresh chili if you want to add some heat to your dish. Number 17. Gung pat sa to. Gung pat sa to. Sa to is a type of bean from the south. It has a strong smell, so some people might not like it. It's just like a durian. Some people are crazy about it, just like me, but some don't like it at all. Sato is most commonly fried with shrimp, but pork is also an option. So now we are number 18. Tom Yam Gung. Tom Yam Gung. I haven't forgot the most famous dish. I'm not going to focus on the details in the dish. As you can see in the pictures how appetizing it is. If you haven't tried this dish, you definitely should. Right now, just go for it, guys. Number 19. Nam prik gapi. Nam prik gapi. This dish is vegetarian friendly. You will enjoy the taste of nam prik by itself and several types of raw veggies. Sometimes we eat it with deep fried mackerel. It can be served as a side dish as well, such as for gang jeot or any food that you want to add some heat. That's it's so tasteless for you, for your tongue. Number 20. Ho mok. If you are looking for a healthy dish, I highly recommend this one. It will not only taste great from the fish, but you will smell herbs and curry paste immediately too. It can be cooked as a vegetarian dish by adding cabbage and other vegetables instead of the fish. For everyone who has been watching this video until now, I have a bonus for you. But before we go to the next dish, please comment. I can't wait. So people who just opened this video wonder what we are talking about. And number 21. Kho mu yang. Kho mu yang. It's kind of risky to order this dish if you don't see it while they are cooking. Kho mu yang is as popular a side dish as gai yang is. If you see kho mu yang on the street and you can see how it looks, then it's alright to eat from that place. But if you go to a restaurant and you can't see their kitchen, or if they don't use a real picture, there is a 70% chance you will get terrible kho mu yang. But if you don't mind greasy fat dish like this, you can go for it. But personally, I don't. If you stuck till the end, hope you guys got some ideas for what to have for dinner. If you want to know more about Isan dishes, please let me know in the comment section below. But if you are a sweet lover, you want some Thai dessert, please let me know too. And that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you next time. Bye!